I'm Michael Harris, associate editor of the Hydro Group for Penwell, and here are this week's Hydro headlines. Starting off in North America, a report released in conjunction with the Canadian Hydropower Association's 2015 Forum on Hydropower underlines the importance of hydro to the country's economy. The study, which relies on data collected by Statistics Canada in 2013, says hydro accounts for 63% of the country's overall power supply, contributes more than $30 billion to Canada's gross domestic product, and supports 135,000 jobs. According to the report, hydroelectric infrastructure accounted for more than $8.3 billion in investments and provided $21.7 billion in revenues from generation, transmission, and distribution. The sector's dominance in Canada is also reflected in a recent ranking of the country's biggest infrastructure projects for 2015, with Site C, Muskrat Falls, Romaine, and Kiask topping the list. CHA's full report is available online at canadahydro.ca. Now in Asia, India's Ministry of Environment and Forest has halted development of the 3,097-megawatt Etalan plant, citing concerns about the project's environmental impact. The $550 million facility was planned for construction along the Dri and Tangon rivers in northeastern state Himachal Pradesh, but would likely have required the removal of more than 275,000 trees. Elsewhere in India, the country's Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has reactivated development of six microprojects as part of its National Mission on Small Hydro. The initiative ultimately seeks to cultivate a cumulative 500 megawatts of small hydro capacity within the next 2 years. Moving to the United States, American hydropower could receive another legislative boost pending the introduction of a draft discussion bill to Congress. The bill, subtitled Hydropower Regulatory Modernization, seeks to streamline the federal permitting process for qualifying hydropower projects of 5 megawatts or less. The legislation was discussed last week by the U.S. House Energy and Commerce Committee, where, testifying on its behalf, Maine Governor Paul LePage said the government has, quote, bigger fish to fry than many of the small hydropower proposals currently awaiting federal approval. Specifically, the regulation would give the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission more authority to approve and administer license requirements, also remove Federal Power Act requirements from projects of 5 megawatts capacity or less, and give FERC the authority to issue exemptions for facilities of 5 megawatts or greater for certain proposals. Full text of the discussion draft is available online at hydroworld.com. And last, those who have attended any of the Power Group's events have likely seen the Penwell Wall of Honor. The Wall of Honor pays tribute to military service personnel, both past and present, from around the world. Inclusion on the wall is free, but to ensure that your submission is included at Hydrovision International 2015, names must be submitted before June 29th. Wall of Honor sponsorship opportunities are also still available, with 100% of all proceeds being donated to Blue Star Mothers. For more information about the Wall of Honor, or to nominate a friend, colleague, or family member, visit hydroevent.com. That's the news for this week. Be sure to check out our LinkedIn, Twitter, and Facebook pages for even more ways to interact. And watch for this newscast each and every week, brought to you by Hydro Consulting and Maintenance Services.